Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Dear viewers, now I will show how to model swimming pool in Etabs and how to apply soil pressure and water pressure. So let's start. Open Etabs program. New model. Click on OK. Number of grid along X direction 2. Y direction 2, for example 10 meter. Length of the swimming pool, width of the swimming pool is 8 meter. Here history 1, height for the swimming pool, for example 3 meter. Click on OK. Now go to define section properties, slab, modify. Bottom slab, okay. Bottom slab, for example 350 millimeter. Click on OK. Define section properties, wall section, modify. W 250. Click on OK. OK. Save this model. Go to base, then click on the quick floor. Bottom slab, select this. Okay, we will assign area spring properties. First we will break this one. This direction we want to break 0.5 meter by 5 meter, so 10 meter. This direction will be 20 and y direction will be 8, 16. Apply. Now we will define load pattern. Dead live load, we will make it W3. Water pressure, modify. Then soil pressure, add. Click on OK. Now here we will apply dead load as a finishing 2 kN per meter square. Previous selection, water pressure, we will calculate this unit weight of water, 10 kN per meter cube. Length of the swimming pool 10 meter, width 8 meter, maximum height of water 3 meter. So volume of water, it is coming 240 meter cube, and water pressure at base, it is coming 30 kN per meter square. Click on 30, apply. Now we will assign area spring. If it is 150 kN per meter square, bearing capacity of soil will provide 150 kN meter per meter square. Compression only. Click on OK. Apply. Done. Now we will model wall for this swimming pool. Go to story 1, wall 250. Now we will apply water pressure and soil pressure to the swimming pool wall. Select the walls, then go to assign shell load non-uniform water pressure. Here load pattern equation is ax plus by plus cz plus d. So we have to provide value for this a, b, c, d constant. So now we will calculate this value for water pressure. This unit weight, soil unit weight 18, surcharge load 12 kN per meter square. We will apply pressure for this swimming pool considering two cases. One is case 1, full water, no soil pressure before backfilling during leakage testing time. And case 2, soil pressure plus surcharge pressure, no water during maintenance. Here surcharge pressure for machineries or any other things we have considered 12 kN per meter square. Height of water 3 meter, height of wall, height of wall side soil, angle of soil friction 30 degree, and sine theta coming from this sine of theta degree. Rankine's coefficient for active soil pressure, this is 1 minus sine theta by 1 plus sine theta. Rankine's coefficient for soil pressure for surcharge load K0, 1 minus sine theta. Water pressure at bottom, so it is coming unit weight of water and height of water 30 kN per meter square. This is at bottom and at top will be 0. Soil pressure at bottom PS1 equal to active pressure coefficient into unit weight of soil and into height of soil, so 18 kN per meter square for soil pressure, and it will be added with surcharge pressure. So surcharge pressure at bottom coming K0 into QA. From this coefficient K0 into surcharge load QA, so it is coming 6 kN per meter square. Total pressure for case 2 is coming 6 plus 18, 24 kN per meter square. For Etabs non-uniform pressure, P equal to AX plus BY plus CZ plus D. Here we can see the pressure working along Z direction non-uniformly. So along X and Y axis the pressure will be 0. So P equal to CZ plus D. So for water pressure case 1, at Z0 pressure is 30. At 3 meter distance pressure is 0. So using these values in this equation, we will get value of D and value of C. Same way for soil plus surcharge pressure case 2, we will get D equal to 24 and C equal to minus 6. So this value we will put in Etabs. For water pressure, this is 30, C is minus 10. This will be applied along local 3 axis. We can check, we'll apply this first, then check local axis. Here we can see this red is local axis 1, green is local axis 2, and blue is local axis 3. So water pressure will act along local axis 3. So close this one and select again previous selection, soil pressure, this is 24 minus 6, 24 minus 6. This soil pressure will act against the local axis 3. That pressure direction we will modify in load case. Now click on apply, now close. We can go to define load case. Here this one will be water pressure. Here you can see load pattern water pressure. Just click on OK. Soil pressure, it will be minus 1, so that the pressure direction can be reversed opposite of local axis 3. Click on OK. OK. Now we will divide the walls. Here 20 by 1 along the Z axis. I will not divide the wall because along Z axis non-uniform pressure is working. So 20 by 1 like this, this two side one 16 by 1, click on apply. Now this is our swimming pool. Now we will assign support for wall. Here go to assign support translation x y, so click on apply. Now we can run analysis to see the displacement. Now we can see here for dead load, this for water pressure acting from inward to outward, soil pressure acting from outward to inward. Now we will define load combination, add soil pressure, dead load 1, water pressure 1, click on OK. Add new water pressure service 1, add copy water pressure ULT ultimate 1.6, click on OK. Add copy soil pressure service 1, click on OK. Add copy soil pressure ULT ultimate 1.6 as it is live load, so scale factor 1.6, click on OK. Now we will go to display soil pressure. Okay, 36.75 kilonewton per meter square at the edges, 60 kilonewton per meter square. Our soil bearing capacity is 150 kilonewton per meter square. Now for wall, we can check our moment. Soil pressure ultimate show deformed shape like this. Moment M22, moment at bottom, maximum at top 0. We can see the value at top 0, maximum at bottom. This is the soil pressure. Now for water pressure ultimate, this is maximum at bottom, 0 at top. So from this moment diagram we can design reinforcement, and from this serviceability check we can check the displacement. Here we can check the displacement, soil pressure service. Here we can check the displacement, it is coming 4.46 millimeter, the displacement for soil pressure. And for water pressure, the displacement for wall coming 3.67 millimeter or 3.72 millimeter maximum. So if we check with allowable deflection as per our design code, for example L by 100, then the length of the wall is 3 meter. So 3000 millimeter divided by 100, it is coming 3 millimeter allowable displacement. So as it is exceeding the allowable displacement, so we have to increase the wall thickness. Same way, using the allowable deflection for this bottom slab, we can check our slab thickness. Then from the moment diagram we can design reinforcement. In this way we can apply water pressure and soil pressure in Etabs. So thanks for watching. Stay tuned for more upcoming tutorials.
Press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update.